Just as all sunlight is considered the nature of the sun, so all experience is the nature of luminous mind. Identify the spaciousness of the support and location of whatever arises, including the entire impure delusory universe, manifest or potential, and everything is suffused by baseless mind and released in the now. Reality is thus defined as the vast space of the matrix of the now, beyond delusion and non-delusion, beyond nominal meaning. Even sublime self-envisioned forms and Buddha fields, and the display of wholly appropriate activity and present awareness, are contained in the self-sprung space that is neither unity nor disunity. Luminous mind comprises the entire universe and samsara and nirvana, all of it non-composite, empty clarity, like sun-dashed space, all of it the vast, pristine, self-sprung matrix of the now. The vast matrix of mind's nature, an unchanging sky-like space, with the creativity of luminous mind indeterminate in its display, governs all the lifestyles of samsara and nirvana. The single principle of non-action underpinning it all. So nothing is extreme, nothing excluded or extraneous, for nothing can stray from the reality of luminous mind. Because everything arises as a unitary, all-good spontaneity, as an all-inclusive, unrivaled, supreme embodiment. The greatest of the great, as all-good intrinsic spaciousness, like an emperor magisterially embodying the state, the whole of samsara and nirvana is passively unmoving. Because all things are all good and not one is not good. Undifferentiated, all things have one value in the all good. Because the true and the false have one value in intrinsic spaciousness, everything is identical in the unmoving sameness of spontaneity. All without exception arises out of the unity of intrinsic spaciousness, where, in non-action, neither quest nor practice can be. Effort and endeavor are only their own intrinsic spaciousness. So whence could effort arise, and to what could endeavor aspire? No place to go, no vision to cultivate, no state to attain, nothing extraneous to assimilate, no coming nor going, the sameness of the Dharmakaya, spontaneous perfection, lies in the spaciousness of the one soul sphere. Disciples, hermits, and bodhisattvas' transmissions, conveying strong conviction in the absence of I and mine, provide a shared, unelaborated sky-like vision. The transmission of the supreme yoga, Ati, the sublime secret, identifies the vast space where self and other are inseparable. With the self-sprung awareness of things in the now, just as they are, thus including the view of the lower approaches in its supreme essence. The three disciplines of Kriya Tantra, Upa Tantra, and Yoga Tantra, relating the yoga into the deity through contemplation and offering, all aspire to the city of immaculate body, speech, and mind. In the Vajra Peak transmissions, the sovereign secret, form, sound, and awareness, already immaculate, comprise the deity of the now. The city of immaculate body, speech, and mind already revealed, the vision of the lower approaches is contained in the supreme essence. In Mahayoga, Anu Yoga and Ati Yoga, fields of Yabhyam deities, constitute the universe of appearances, spiritual and material. And since intrinsic spaciousness is inseparable from immaculate primal awareness in the now, reality in its stillness is self-sprung awareness itself. In this most sublime secret, everything is already immaculate. And the vast uncreated matrix of the now is an actual field of bliss. In that all-pervasive plenum, without outside and inside, no discriminating progressive endeavor can stand. And since everything is submerged in the now, liberated in the vast matrix of the Dharmakaya, those lower visions are gathered into the secret heart of Ati. Complete in one, complete in some, the matrix that contains all possible experience itself is contained in magnificent spontaneity, in its intrinsic clarity, disposed in the now.